thanks for coming back and checking out another challenge lock video. We have got a nasty Avis with some horrible warding in the vise. It's been pinned by Brian Easton and it's called the Contender, and it works lovely, but it is a bitch to tension. I've been using the pry bars top. I've been putting it in like that and trying to do it that way, and nothing is working, so I'm going to have a go from the back and we'll see how we get on this time. Pin.
This is the village of Bingo in the west of the country. The people here are not starving, but they are very poor. Jesus here has to exist on a diet of miserable gruel, which is fine for silly rich women in London and New York, but food like this makes the average red-blooded African man very sad. And that's odd, because just 200 miles away, things are very different. This is Mozambique's capital city, Maputo. And the people here are well-nourished and happy, because they live by the ocean, which is full of fish. And I was wondering, how hard can it be to get the fish from here to that village we were looking at earlier?
Yeah, now this isn't a very wealthy country, in fact it's a poor country.
Yes. Desperately poor.
Desperately poor. So they don't have refrigerated trucks, all that kind of stuff.
No, but we're talking about 200 miles. That's London to Leeds, isn't it? It's nothing to get this there.
I'm telling you, when we get this sorted out, when we move these fish to Bingo, there'll be Nobel Prizes in it for us.
Maybe Boutros Boutros.
Yes.
Maybe Ban Ki-moon.
Oh, Ban Ki-moon.
Yeah.
I'm going to go for a knighthood.
Do it. Why not?
Beat David Beckham.
Tell you then, well. Unfortunately, having agreed that we would end world hunger by moving fish across Mozambique, we couldn't agree on how this might be achieved. So we ended up with different solutions. This is what I came up with, a 1984 Mercedes wagon. A car famous throughout Africa for its rugged dependability. However, I have modified it extensively in the back. Filling up all of the back is a Perspex tank. What I'm going to do is fill that with seawater and then put the fishes in there, and they will stay alive as I make my way inland. Now, you can't get fish fresher than fishes that are still swimming around in the sea. I have been clever. Very clever.
Not as clever as me, because for the first time in my entire life, I've made a sensible decision. Gone for this. It's a pickup truck that Nissan named after me. It's called the Hard Body. It's got tons of space in the back for cod and bream and sticklebacks. And it has four-wheel drive, which I reckon is going to be essential because, and James hasn't realised this, it's the rainy season in Mozambique, so I reckon the roads are going to be hell. Hammond, meanwhile, hadn't been clever at all.
What do you think of that?
Well, I think it's a motorcycle.
Yes, it is specifically, it's a TVS Star HNX E5, and I've just bought this brand new from a supermarket for 800 quid. Brand spankers.
Hammond, this is not a quality item.
Well, no, it's built down to a budget, isn't it? You can feel that.
That's 1,000cc?
No, 100.
What?
100cc.
How many cylinders? Four.
One.
What?
One. That one.
How much horsepower is it?
Seven.
Seven?
Seven. But it's light, it's agile. These things are actually built in India specifically to be used in Africa. They are. They're built in India specifically for use in Africa.
It's too poor to be used in India.
No,
it's
rugged, it's tough, it can go off-road if we need to. It can do anything.
Yeah, but what it can't do, Hammond, is transport a large amount of fish.
Exactly what I was thinking. If I wanted a pizza delivery, this is the sort of thing that looks like.
I thought about this. Let me explain my idea. This is Majid's. What they're doing here, right, they dry the fish in the wind like that because it lasts longer.
Is that fish?
That's fish drying in the wind, so what I'm going to do...
That looks like cats.
No, it's fish. I'm going to build a rack like that, put it to the back of a bike, and then I'll dry the fish as I go along. It's brilliant.
That is literally the stupidest idea I've ever heard of.
Well, what are you going to do? Sling your fish in the back of your
bike? There we go.
No, actually, I
feel a little bit of a cheat by doing it from the back. But, yeah, we got there in the end. And let's have a bushes and see what we've got inside there.
Break into a hotel in the dead of night and do a burglary.
So that's fully open and we got the key, so I'll lock it back up and we'll be able to...
He's not going to do it.
There we go, so you can see everything needed to be picked. And yeah, I'm not sure if there's any work. Been done to the that feels all standard. Lovely big spool pin in one.
That's my gearbox.
No, no, no! Oh, you pillock.
Hammond, there's a really bad noise.
Yeah.
Dropped it right where the sewage is.
Okay.
There's a terrible noise coming from the bottom of my gear lever when it's under load.
Right, that spring's not coming out. Some lovely pins there.
Hold on, James. This is how they do it here.
No, that's the wrong way. We'll go the other way.
Oh, geez, I'm on the wrong side. I think
it's there. Turn it. Oh! You know. As Hammond and Ollie were struggling to get into a rhythm.
Oh, hang on.
No, you've got it.
And the oars come out.
Oh. And as it turned out, the Indian Ocean wasn't that deep.
Where has all the sea gone?
We decided to push the boat instead.
Any minute now, we're going to start fishing. Right, I think this might actually be working. If they can just get themselves back to here, we've got two ends of a
dart. So we've got some nice pins there.
Pull it in, full of fish. Ugh! Shit! I've caught myself in the net!
We've got some lovely ones. These have got like little bits on the ends. Just to catch with a spool in the middle. I'm not sure if he's made these ones himself, Brian, or if he's got these out of other locks or purchased them. But yeah, some really, really nice pins there.
Right,